Matt is set for one fall, being accompanied to the ring by Ezekiel from Venice, California, weighing 184 pounds, the Brian Kendrick.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Brian Kendrick, who last week I said was somewhat Pillman-esque, as in intellect and self-confidence, has a bona fide swagger and a bona fide monster in Ezekiel in his corner.
Apparently, he also has something on his mind, JR.
Now, let me make something perfectly clear to all you people. There's been no attitude change. I've always been the Brian Kendrick. I always have been this way. And yet, when I said I was the most intelligent superstar in all the WWE, I meant exactly that. I go out and I find a partner in Paul London, and I put on a phony smile, and it got my foot in the door. Now, if any of you people think I ever cared about you, do care about you, will care about you, you're all mistaken. I never have cared, and I never will care about any of you. But of course, if anybody has any problems with that, well, you can feel free to take it up with my man, Zeke.
Wow.
And his opponent from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 230 pounds, Stevie Richards.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Stevie Richards will give us 100% of heart in this match. We know that. We saw Richards make a gallant attempt on not one but two occasions against the undefeated Moscow and Baller, but I got to thank Mick, and I know you know Stevie very well, that Stevie Richards is more than likely the underdog in this matchup.
Well, maybe a slight underdog. I have to respect that Kendrick's intelligence. Anybody who can go out and hire his man Zeke is showing some intelligence.
And find a jacket. That retro jacket is another
The bedazzler is big this year.
Yes.
In a down economy, you got to relocate those bedazzlers, JR.
And let's not take anything away from Stevie Richards, but can Brian Kendrick maintain his role? And Kendrick very, very proficient in using the kicks to knot up the hamstrings and the quads, the quadricep muscle of a lot of bigger opponents. And we talk about this young man's intellect. Pillman knows that. Well, there I go. Brian Kendrick knows a lot of ways to break a larger opponent down.
Yeah, you remember the old saying, speed kills, and this kid is lightning quick. And knows his holds.
I knew there was a face there someplace between that hair and the arms of Stevie Richards. Did get his head kicked off. A little camel clutch-like action there before those cross faces came pounding in.
Kendrick really seems to relish this not the new attitude, but the spotlight on him, on his attitude. Likes the crowd booing him.
And now the hook of the leg after the unique offense, and Brian Kendrick has wrestled thus far a mistake. Free match.
How about it, Stevie? What are you saying there? How about it?
And the Boston crowd in Harrison, or near Harrisonburg, here in Hershey, PA.
You saying no in there? How about it, Stevie? Talk to me.
I think you're confusing Harrisburg and Mechanicsburg, JR. If Brian Kendrick's so intelligent, why doesn't he own a barbecue restaurant, and why hasn't he written a number one bestseller, huh?
Well, let's don't get on the wrong side of his man Zeke. You know what I'm saying? Look at that kick. Again, no wasted motion by Brian Kendrick. Kendrick very proficient. We've seen it even more and more using his kicks instead of his fists and using them very effectively. And the cover here, how long has Stevie Richards been off his vertical base?
Most of the match. And I have to tell you from experience that when you wrestle a guy like the Kendrick, an annoying guy, a guy that you deep down don't like, it can throw you off your game.
Now, you were on the money about 3 weeks ago when you said that you had never really liked Brian Kendrick if you thought he'd always been a jerk. I certainly wasn't aware of that, his personality.
Well, he was always running to the ring and always wearing that little mask and with the attempt-like shorts. He didn't really have a chance to focus on his personality.
Kendrick, Kendrick made a mistake.
Get him, Stevie.
Stevie Richards just retaliating with kicks of his own.
Oh, yeah.
Hard shot to the spine. And Kendrick not the only man that can kick the cover. And a near fall by Stevie Richards, who just exploded after Kendrick made one small error. Look out! Powerbomb! Another mistake. This time it's a fatal. No, not a fatal, but almost a fatal mistake.
So close, and I can't help but wonder what a defeat like that at the hands of Richards would have done to the mental makeup of the Kendrick.
Well, the Kendrick is trying to roll out of bounds, but and referee Nicky Henson. The big Zeke just. Kendrick didn't hit the contract. Zeke just caught the Kendrick in midair.
Look at the welts on the back of the Kendrick. He's really laying in those boots and chops.
And
no, don't turn around. There's that injured throw to Stevie Richards.
Stevie Richards took his eye off his opponent, put him on Big Zeke, and the Kendrick just hit the Kendrick. Ladies and gentlemen, we're seeing something evolve here on Friday Night SmackDown with the Brian Kendrick and his man Zeke.
Yeah, I was impressed by Richard, but even more so by the Kendrick. He took one moment of opportunity, and capitalized. That's what he needs to do. Get to the top of SmackDown.
Brian Kendrick blowing disingenuous kisses. Hey, wait a minute.
Come on, Zeke.
Good Lord. What the heck? Big Zeke with a bud breaker. Look at this rack. The strength of Ezekiel. Just toying with Stevie Richards. Brian Kendrick has a very dangerous and deadly associate.
Now the phrase taking up with Zeke has a whole new meaning, JR.
Brian Kendrick very proud of his results here, winning again, but look at this, the Kendrick.
It is called the Kendrick.
And then after the match, ladies and gentlemen, we saw just how strong, just how deadly, just how powerful Ezekiel is. Our first time to see the brute force of this man using that overhead backbreaker effectively. And Ezekiel's presence has already built a new echo. We are dead.